If you are flying this summer, get ready for some unwelcome surprises. At least one major airport is warning passengers to expect delays.
And flyers are being hit with new fees. CBS News travel editor Peter Greenberg is with us. Peter, good morning. All right, what? Yeah. More fees? What for?
Just when you thought it couldn't get worse, it's getting worse. Welcome to the home of the brave and the land of the fee. Did you like that one? Okay, let's move on. Here's the deal.
United Airlines.
I got more. United Airlines actually increased the cost of changing your ticket from $150 to $200 on a domestic ticket. That's right. Just a change fee. And to make matters worse, on an international ticket, it went up to $300. And let me give you some history here. In the past, when one airline would want to raise their fees, at least one competing airline would always hold back. It was usually the weakest carrier. And then it wouldn't hold. There are no weak carriers now. So when one airline raises the fees, they all go along. And that's exactly what happened this time. United raised the fee to $200, and now all the major carriers have gone along with them.
Also, bag fees.
That's right. The bag fees have always gone up, but now they're trying to tier them so that they have a way to be able to basically, you know, mitigate the pain. Mm-hmm. But the problem here is this. The airlines now are all making money. So they're all going along with the same increase, and there's no way out in that respect. It's just getting worse. Now, Frontier Airlines, you mentioned the coffee. Let's get to that. Yeah. Frontier Airlines is saying, okay, if you show up at the gate with a bag that you haven't registered first, mm-hmm. $100.
That you haven't registered.
Meaning you haven't paid for their $25 or $35 bag fee before you got to the airport. Yeah. Now it's going to cost you $100. That's what Spirit Airlines was doing last year. Now Frontier is going along with it. Now that Frontier is doing it, how long will it take for the other airlines to match that? And then here comes the coffee. $1.99 for a cup of coffee on Frontier, and $1 if you want the water. Now I have a way around that. Yeah. You want the way around that?
Yes.
Okay.
Of course.
I'm on medication. I need to take my pills. I have to have my water, or I could snap at any minute.
Right.
But they can still say, well, you still have to pay for it.
When you say, I need my medication, it's amazing how they get the message.
Right. So you're not saying anybody should ever lie, Peter.
Yeah. No, but when you have a country that's basically on medication anyway, let's go. You know.
So this is all going to cause delays.
Well, that's the other area. And that's what's going on at Atlanta over the weekend. The officials at Atlanta Hartsfield and Delta Airlines basically sent out a letter saying, guys, be careful. You're going to have serious delays. Get there at least 90 minutes, even for a domestic flight, ahead of that flight. And the reason why this is happening has nothing to do with sequestration. It has to do with staffing cuts and budget cuts that was existing prior to that. At Atlanta, you had 22 security lines in which only 13 were being used.
Okay, but the headline is you think this is going to grow to other airports.
Oh, it already has.
Yeah.
I mean, I talked to the guys in Miami, the TSA guys in Miami, the guys in Chicago, Dallas, LA, those choke point airports, they're not staffing all of those lines. And when you have summer numbers that are going to be much higher than ever, basic math.
I've seen it at Reagan.
Yeah. Makes you thankful you have a G5, doesn't it?
I want to be on that plane.
Peter,
no,
thank
you're
you.
Joking.